Hello, everyone. I'm Mason. This is John, Selena, and Sarah. And today we're here on behalf of Paradise Produce to talk to you guys about the global food waste epidemic, the ugly food problem that's prevalent here in the United States and really all across the globe, and our UT Dallas Fruit Initiative to help push back against food waste here in Dallas with our UTD students. Before we get started, we're going to play a brief video to really explain what is ugly food and really the opportunity within that domain to help push back against food waste.
Feed in the 5,000 is a celebration of the solutions to food waste, where we feed 5,000 people a delicious meal made entirely out of foods that would otherwise have gone to waste. America is a country which has a massive problem with food waste. 40% of the food isn't consumed.
A huge amount of perfectly good food is being wasted all the way up and down the supply chain. You start on the farms, you go to manufacturers, wholesalers, restaurants, and of course in our home.
Food has been rejected because it's too ugly, the wrong shape or size. So these cauliflowers, for example, perfectly delicious and edible, they've just got a few blemishes and the wholesalers weren't able to sell them.
And we go in, we intervene, we say, don't chuck that away, give it to us, we're gonna cook it up, 5,000 people.
We had 800 pounds of just the sweet potatoes today, and that's just the beginning. We have hundreds and hundreds of pounds of food that would otherwise have gone to waste that we're putting to good use. We've got teams of 4 to 6 chopping vegetables around big round tables while they listen to the music and enjoy the day.
So right now we are putting the finishing touches on the 5,000 meals of vegetable curry that we've started preparing yesterday and will be serving to the community today.
It's up to us, the citizens of this country, of this world, to say we're fed up with food waste and it's time to take food waste off the menu.
Some people call them Frankenfish.
So as you guys can see in the video, there's a tremendous opportunity within the space of ugly food. There are many entrepreneurs and businesses who have already taken advantage of this, and they're really trying to identify opportunities to help these producers maximize their revenues by really selling ugly foods. As you guys saw, a lot of these producers aren't able to sell a lot of the foods just because of cosmetic defects. So what really is ugly food? Producers have certain standards for cosmetics as to what certain foods, vegetables, fruits should look like before they can be sold to producers and or distributors and eventually down to the consumer. And so as you guys can see, the United States, due to this, throws away about a third of all the food that they produce. 133 billion pounds of food are thrown away a year, and at the grocery store level, about 10% of this is just because of ugly foods. So that's 13 billion pounds of food that there's a potential opportunity to create an opening for UT Dallas students to really step in and help us solve this issue. So what exactly is fruit, and how can it help? Fruit is our collaborative effort to really push back against food waste, starting with UT Dallas students. So when really brainstorming this idea, we were trying to come up with where is there an opportunity for ugly food to be used and how can these guys really maximize these resources. And when looking at the UT Dallas demographic for students, we came across a conclusion that a lot of the things these guys share in common are really, in most cases, a lot of students have low to little income, relatively high expenses for really where they are in life. A lot of these guys are pretty young. And so many students can really use discounted, healthier option, whether it's to make smoothies or to get a healthier meal in the day, rather than going to a dollar menu and getting a $2 hamburger from McDonald's. So something really cool with this is how we're going to tackle food waste here in Dallas. College students now have the opportunity to eat a little healthier on a budget. Rather than going to McDonald's or a fast food chain, they can get discounted, uglier produce that's perfectly tasty and edible. Furthermore, farmers will still make revenue off of produce that would have been rejected from the grocery store originally. Now this is a huge opportunity, and at some point later in the presentation my teammates are going to touch on it, but what's really cool is that this initiative is really self-sustaining and it allows for growth in and among itself, really to stretch from UT Dallas to other universities potentially. And so now I'm going to take it off to Selena and she'll talk a little bit about why this is really good for UT Dallas.
So as y'all can see, I have a UTD meal plan posted right there. They are relatively high. The cheapest one is about $1,001. That gives you 5 meals a week and then $100 meal money. So obviously 5 meals a week won't feed you for all 3 meals in a week period. So then what most people have to do, which most students have to do, they have to go to these other on-campus options like Subway, IHOP,
I'm Sign Bagels, Jason's Deli Pub, and I personally ate at Panda Express last week, and I spent $8 on a Panda Express bowl. And then I kind of thought, and I was thinking if I would do this Monday through Friday to get one meal that's separate from my meal plan, that would eventually go over $600 for... That'd be over $600 for a semester. So that would be over $600 additional to my $1,000. And then I'm pretty sure I still wouldn't have enough money to give me my three necessary meals to really keep me going as a student, get good grades, be energetic. So we want to start at UTD, as Mason said. We eventually want to branch out, but we believe that because this is our home front, we really want to start here. And if we find any glitches, we're gonna fix it here, and then we're gonna feel comfortable kind of getting out into the wider Dallas area. So there's a total of 26,800 students at UTD. Of those 26,800, there's about 6,200 that are international students. So what does this mean? International students are typically vegetarian-based. They have a vegetarian-based diet, and based on their culture, they would like to stick with that even if they are here in school in the U.S. But many have to stray away from this because it's very expensive to eat salads even. Like, there's $6, $7, $8 salads just so they can really stay true to their culture. So many stray away from this, and they will go to vending machines, Cane's, McDonald's, anything that's kind of in the area. And we looked into this, and we found out that in the U.S., there's 20 to 30% of all students have food insecurity. So that gives UTD roughly 5,000 to 8,000 students that are food insecure. And now I'm going to pass it over to Jonathan. He's going to explain food insecurities even more.
Thank you, Selena. So what exactly is food insecurity? Now, I know what you're thinking, but I assure you, it's not an orange that feels like it looks fat in its own peel. It's actually a state of being without reliable access to a sufficient quantity of affordable or nutritious food. Now, basically that means is nutritious food is too expensive to even give it a second thought. And that's not good. Most of us don't have enough money to go and buy a salad or have the time to go to the grocery store to go and get fruit or anything like that. So we opt out for the dollar cheeseburger, which is bad. It ends up, in the long run, you'll end up with health problems. It can give you emotional stress. As college students, you already have stress as it is. It can also end up affecting your academics. So we want to give healthier alternatives. It's said that on each plate, you're supposed to have 50% of it filled up with fruits and vegetables. We want to be able to give students at UTD the opportunity to fill their plates up without breaking the bank. Generally speaking, easy food is bad. I mean, just because it's easy doesn't mean you have to go for it. So basically what we're trying to do is we want to make it easy to obtain at discounted prices, plus help them be able to fill up their plates with 50% more fruits and vegetables, and in turn end up giving them improved academics and healthier lifestyle. Now I'm going to hand it over to Sarah.
All right, so here's the fun stuff, the budget. So I've broken down the entire initiative to three parts, direct material, direct labor, and overhead. Overhead costs would be, majority of it would be the car due to licensing issues, insurance, and vendoring fees. But in the overhead costs, there would be advertisement, ordering sheets, and crates. Okay, so total budget. The total startup costs would be just the overhead costs, which is going to be around $3,500. And for daily costs would be around $300, and that's just three workers working at $9 an hour for 8 hours with 50 order sheets. So based on the forms, and off of farmers. Damaged produce are typically sold 40% off compared to their non-damaged counterpart goods, right? So there's a wide variety of different type of produces in Texas. Some of them would go up to $4, which is a high of $3.46 and a low of 19 cents. So I took the average to give it a fair part gain, all right? So from the fruits that Paradise Produce has bought, they're gonna do a 20% markup. The 20% markup with the average is gonna be $2.19, and with that number, we are able to calculate the break-even costs for pounds. So the break-even cost from pounds for startup costs alone is gonna be around 1,500 pounds. And for daily costs, we just need to sell 135 pounds. And also some other facts before I get to my next point. The average American eats around 730 pounds of produce a year, which actually comes down to 17 pounds a week, 2 pounds a day. Which, using from Dell's facts, you were able to calculate the break even for how many people we need to sell in order to break even, which actually gives to the average of 385 people for startup costs and only 4 people for daily costs, right? So here's the magic number. We're asking the Chamber of Commerce to give us $37,000. Yeah, and I know what you're thinking. What is the point of calculating break-even costs if the Chamber of Commerce is gonna grant us this money? Well, basically, I want to make the point that based on the break-even numbers, this is sustainable. This could be long-lasting. And on top of that, and it's not wasting your money at all. We're actually providing fruit and providing these college students to eat much more healthier. And on top of that, we're generating money. And with that money that we have generated, the profits will be used to reinvest back into the fruit initiative for growth to expand to other Dallas locations. So it could be from SMU, UNT, or University of Dallas. And basically the logistics of how this fruit initiative is going to work is we are planning on coming to UTD once a week, and when we will set up at the plinth where everyone could just come and buy their fruits. And for the people who cannot come and get their fruits, we have ordering sheets for them to fill out and for the people on site to fulfill those orders, just so we can make it a little bit extra easier for everyone to eat healthier and get those produce needed. So what I'm trying to say is the fruit initiative is we aim to tackle food waste, food insecurity, and an overall lifestyle. It's the same thing. It just looks different. Any questions?